What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. This is Eric, and today the Giants will be in Houston for game two, and so will Hum Baby Baseball. We'll be covering the game. I will do a stadium review, and the Giants need a big bounce back win after losing yesterday, thanks in large part to the player of the game, Mauricio Dubon, the former Giant, who was just awesome for the Astros, and he's having a great season for the Houston Astros, no doubt about it. But the real controversy came after the game, when Mauricio Dubon was asked how he feels about the Giants right now and how, you know, they could probably use his help. And he's like, well, thank God they don't, because he's good where he's at. Because he said he was mistreated in San Francisco. And he said something along the lines of, you know, he wasn't getting enough playing time over in San Francisco, and a couple things. Now, there could be things that we don't know about, and he's just being honest that he was mistreated. That's how he feels. And I really don't have a problem with it, because I listened to it and the tone and everything. It's not like he just trashed the Giants. He didn't say trash organization, a bunch of, you know, he didn't trash anyone. He didn't mention names. He didn't talk bad about the fans. It would have been nice if he said something nice. I enjoyed my time there. The fans are awesome. But that would have been nice. But he chose not to say anything nice. It's fine. I still like him. I think he's a cool guy and he's a good player. But he's not a great player. And when he was here, I don't even think he was good much of the time. And that's the thing I'm about to get to. The thing about Dubon is we gave him an opportunity. The Giants gave him a full opportunity. He was our everyday player basically in 2020. He played almost every game. He was an everyday guy. And he was okay. But the problem with Dubon is, first of all, he doesn't bring a lot of power. He doesn't work a lot of walks. So he has a good bat. He's a good hitter. But when you take that into account, and also the fact that he makes so many mental errors, or at least he did while he was here, base running blunders, defensive mistakes, mental errors, things that really shouldn't happen very often at the MLB level. So he was making those mistakes. And then you also get that kind of low on base percentage and not a ton of power. And we gave him time, and he just wasn't really showing a ton of improvement. So at some point, I think it was time to move on, and I think that we are better now with Tyro Estrada. It would be nice, yes, of course, to have Dubon in the system. But we helped him. We sent him to Houston, and now he's thriving over there at the moment. So, hey, I mean, we traded him, and we didn't get nothing good for him. We got Michael Papirski. All due respect to Michael Papirski. I mean, I'm sure he's a great baseball player, but as far as MLB level, he wasn't really the guy that we needed at that time. We have a lot of catching prospects. I really didn't understand that trade. I think he's a guy that works some walks. He's a Farhan guy, but, like, there's no way I'm trading Dubon. Even with everything I just said, I still wouldn't trade Dubon for just Papirski. I'd try to get some prospects. Can we get two or three prospects and that we like and see if they work out? That would have made a little more sense to me, but I digress. Bottom line is Dubon had his opportunity here. He didn't play that great. He was all right. He showed a lot of promise, but never really put it together. And was it unprofessional? I mean, I didn't think he said it in the most unprofessional, nasty way or anything. I think he was just being honest. And we do, you know, I do appreciate a little bit of honesty in interviews, so it's not all the bland, you know, coach talk and just, you know, just political kind of style where you don't say anything controversial, you know. Sometimes let these players, you know, vent a little bit and let their thoughts be known. And he wasn't happy with the playing time he got here. In my opinion, he got enough playing time to prove himself, and he never really did that. So that's my thoughts on it, but I appreciate his honesty, and we're going to be honest as well. But I still wish Mauricio Dubon the best of luck, except for today and tomorrow. But after that, I wish you the best of luck, Mauricio Dubon, in your career. And just stop, you know, tearing it up against the Giants. That's all I ask. But other than that, honestly, though, in all honesty, I do best of luck to Mauricio Dubon. And I think that he's going to be fine. And obviously, once, you know, Altuve comes back, I would assume his playing time is going to drop a little bit. But he's proven something. And he's going to continue to get opportunities after what he's done this year. He's having a great season. So let me know what you guys think of his comments, though. Was he out of line? Was that unacceptable? Or is he just being honest, giving his thoughts, even if we kind of disagree with his analysis there? Although we don't know the whole story. Maybe there was some mistreatment in the background. We don't know the whole story, obviously. But just as far as the way he played and as far as his playing time, I think that was about right. The Giants gave him an opportunity, never really showed up completely to prove that he was ready to be an everyday player. But let me know what you guys think down below. Be ready tonight. Let's go, Giants. What do you think? We're going to talk to y'all very soon. See ya.